What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about what is better, spot, trading, private sales, or meme coins. Now, all of these have their benefits, and all of these ultimately have their drawbacks. I'm investing and doing all of these, so I feel like I have a good place to explain this. And obviously, I've been full-time crypto now for almost 3 years, and I've been living off crypto for almost 3 years, and I can assure you that some of these have made me way more money than others. And there's one here in particular that I absolutely hate and I don't really do, and I'm pretty sure you could probably figure it out. So let's get into it, because by the end of today's video, I want you to be able to pick the right path for you, you know, because for me, I didn't really have a clear mentor for this, and I would love for you guys to kind of have like a clear thing to focus on. And ultimately, maybe try and get exposed to a few of these different things, see which ones you prefer. So let's get into it. So we've got spot, we've got trading, we've got private sales, and we've got meme coins. So when I say spot, that just means buying on the market at the market price and just setting and forgetting. This is a great way to make money, especially if you have a lot of money. Like, let's say, for example, you've got a few hundred K, or you've got like $1 million, for example, and you want to put it all into BTC or ETH. That's a great play. You just put it, set, and forget. There's also a lot of staking opportunities with spot holdings, so you can actually get some passive income. For example, with paid network, or actually a better example would actually be Pepe. If you hold Pepe, you get paid out in based AI, and I made a video about that. You can go check it out. I'll put it in one of the cards here. But you're getting consistent staking rewards, which is great. So you can set and forget, and you don't need to be an active investor necessarily to benefit from spot. This is great for people that have a lot of money, but also I do a little bit of spot as well, because at the end of the day, why not just have a nice little portfolio growing in the background while you make some other plays with meme coins, trading, and private sales? And we'll get into that. Another benefit as well is it's also really easy to track your portfolio with spot. You know, you can use something like CoinGecko, for example, and you can just track every single thing that you've invested into, and it's really clear. Whereas with like private sales or meme coins, or with trading especially, it's really hard to figure out like what your P&L is, and it's kind of all over the place. The only negatives I would say with spot is that you are going to miss out on day-to-day opportunities that arise with things like meme coins, or with really good potential plays, like when the CME gap happens and things like that. And this is actually one that I really want to talk about, is that I think there's a lack of accelerated learning when it comes to spot. Like, when you're in meme coins every day, or you're trading, or you're investing into private sales and you're learning about that game, there's just so much going on every hour, let alone every day, that there's almost like an accelerated learning that's happening as an investor and as somebody that's, you know, getting into crypto. So I think spot is great if you want to take a more passive role in crypto. Maybe you're a business owner, maybe you have other businesses. That's what I did as an agency owner. I originally just invested into BTC and ETH. But obviously now that I'm full-time crypto, I do a lot of other things. But yeah, I definitely feel like I learned less when I was just spot investing. So that's spot. Now, trading is probably the one that I do the least of. And the reason for that, I'll explain in a second. One of the reasons is I've been liquidated many times while trading, right? I think trading is probably one of the worst things that new investors or new people into crypto can get into. I think it's like, because it sounds the sexiest, you know, you just put a trade on, close the trade, and bang, you made $1,000. But that's so far from reality. Sometimes you will get lucky and that will happen, but it's so rare. But there are many benefits to trading. Like, for example, you can make money on both sides of the price action. You can make money on things going up, and you can make money on things going down. And there's also set and forget trades where you can have a more passive role with, like swing trades, for example. You can set, you can get into a trade and just leave it for a few months, a few weeks, a few days even. So that's really cool. And once you've mastered this, like a great guy, for example, is like Coach K. Once you've mastered this as a skill, it's like infinite money glitch. You can basically create money out of thin air, especially if you understand about liquidity and market making. You can basically just make money out of nothing. It's kind of crazy, to be honest. You can control the price action of certain projects. It's beautiful. The only downsides to trading, obviously, as I mentioned the ones before, but it can also be quite stressful as well. Like when you get liquidated, I remember I was in Birmingham and I remember getting liquidated for almost $16,000 in one trade. I think it was during the Luna collapse. And it fucking broke me, man. I was like, fuck. Like, just in literally 30 seconds, put the trade on, bang, instantly wiped out 16 grand. And at the time, that was a lot of money for me. And I was, you know, stressed out, you know, just to lose 16 grand in one trade. So it can be quite stressful. And then on top of that, people don't really understand leverage. So they use a lot of leverage, that they'll go 100x leverage and they'll get liquidated. They don't understand how that game works. So it's also, there's also a lot of time it takes to become great at trading. It's a 10,000 hour rule one trading for sure. And that's a few years of learning. And with learning comes a lot of mistakes, which means it is going to cost you money to learn this skill. So if you're a new person in crypto, I would urge you to maybe focus more on spot or meme coins or even private sales. Trading is just like, trading's almost, in my opinion, one of those things where, like, you know you're going to lose money, but you just got to get through those few years of learning the skill until you eventually actually have some sort of skill set in it. It's a bit like jiu-jitsu. The first fucking 6 months, 12 months, you're going to be getting your ass whooped, guaranteed, no doubt about it. And then over time, you get a little bit better and you start to actually enjoy it. Whereas in the beginning, it feels like it's fucking shit. You're like, why am I even doing this? But that brings us on to private sales. Now, private sales, hands down, are the thing that's made me the most money in crypto. Private sales, in a short term, are basically where you're getting into projects that haven't launched yet. Early stage deal flow. So projects that haven't launched, and you're usually getting in at a cheaper price. The only caveat to that is you have vesting. So you have to wait for your money. So you might get 10% of your money over 10 months, right? So 100% takes 10 months. But you're getting in so early in comparison to the retail market that there's just a lot of, it's really easy to make money with private sales. And private sales are also great for business owners. You know, a lot of our group, we have over, we're getting close to 300 people in our private group now. And a lot of those people are business owners. They just want to set and forget. And private sales are perfect for that. You can set and forget. And I don't want to say, you know, quote unquote, my legal team's going to piss me off. But you could almost say, some guaranteed returns. You can't guarantee anything, but there's almost guaranteed returns with private sales because you're getting in so much cheaper than somebody else at retail that it's unlikely that retail people are going to even sell at the earliest price that they got into. So it's really easy to make money, and you can kind of protect yourself from, you know, the real bottoms of the price action. So that's one reason I really like private sales. And it's also, it's really hard to get into, which I'll get into in a second. But once you do get into them, there's like a whole ecosystem with private sales. And private sales can go crazy. You can make 300x on a private sale, 1000x on a private sale. I've been part of projects like ShopX, like Dreams Quest, both of these doing over 200x's, you know. Even recently, I got into a project, Trueflation, which was a 22x, 9% a month. So your 9% covered double your initial investment. So it's really profitable. The only negatives and downsides with private sales are a few different things. Number one, they're extremely hard to access. It's almost impossible for you as a retail investor to get into private sales. The only way you can get in is by either being a big agency owner, a big VC, or a big influencer. And luckily for you guys watching this channel, I'm all three of those things. So we can get you into private sales, but it's extremely hard to. And even when I first started, I couldn't get in. I had to come in with a lot of value. Me and Taro had to figure out a lot of shit. And the second reason is because they can also struggle in the bear market, but everything struggles in the bear market, but private sales especially, they kind of get shit on a little bit in the bear market, but that's okay. You know, you can buy the bottom and so on. There's also the concept now that there's a lot of high FDV projects that probably, you know, they start the launch at like a $20 million valuation. And some of these projects are too big and there's not enough like room to make big gains in them, you know? So there's also that as well. But that also leads us onto meme coins, right? Which are just fucking insane. You can make crazy returns and you can do it with a very small amount of money. Even in the last like couple weeks, I've made so much money from meme coins. And obviously you guys saw my video where I went from 2K to 50K in 12 days. It's insane. The fact that you can turn $2,000 into 50,000 is insane in just under 12 days. And even recently I've been putting 0.5 sol, 1 sol into a bunch of different meme coins. And then even yesterday I put 0.5 sol into one coin and it went to 4 sol. You know, within like literally 30, I think about 30 minutes. So just to do that is fucking insane. It's basically unheard of. And there's so much opportunity to make in meme coins. Because there's meme coins every single day, the study came out around 20,000 to 25,000 meme coins are created every single day. If you've ever went to the website Pump Fund, you'll know what I mean. It's just spamming a bunch of different meme coins. And I kind of like meme coins because they take the seriousness out of crypto. Sometimes when you're looking at private sales, you're looking at the utility, the technology, the team. You don't really need to do that with meme coins. It's just, is it, does it make you laugh? And is it ridiculous enough to probably pump? And does it follow like a narrative like Trump Mania, for example, that's pumping right now because, you know, Trump's getting arrested or he's going to jail. Who fucking knows what's going on with that? So there's a lot of benefits to meme coins. And to be honest, every single person in crypto should be getting into meme coins, especially right now while the narrative is high. You should be doing it. The only negatives with meme coins, as I'm sure you can imagine, is price action can change extremely quickly. Whereas with a private sale, you can just set and forget. The price action of a meme coin can change instantly. Within 30 seconds, it can be down 40%. And that can be scary and can stress a lot of people out. And ultimately, with meme coins, you can get rugged and you many times, and a lot of the time, you will get wrecked. Meme coins almost have a spray and pray mentality to them where you'll invest into five different projects and one will hit, you know? But that's probably closer to like 10 projects will go to shit and one or two will go fucking crazy and rip and cover the cost of all of your other ones. So as you can see, guys, there's many different benefits and there's many pros and cons to spot trading, private sales and meme coins. I think if you're watching this and you're new, definitely get into meme coins. And definitely hold a little bit spot just so you can get used to it, especially if this is your first cycle, just to have a little play around. And you know what? Fuck it. Even have a little play around with trading, but just don't do anything that you're willing to lose. I just want you guys to get exposed to this because time in the market is worth more than money in the market. And at the end of the day, the only reason that I'm successful in crypto is because I've been doing it forever, right? If I go my first day into a jiu-jitsu class, I get smoked because I don't know anything. And it's the same with crypto. You have to get exposed to it. I think sometimes people think of making money as making money, whereas making money is a representation and is a representation of the skills that you have. You know, time in the market is worth more than money in the market. So once you have skills, it's easy for you to make money. So if you're new, try out all of these. If you've got low amounts of money, definitely stick with like meme coins. If you've got a good amount of money, like a, you know, average amount, let's say anywhere from like 5K to 20K, definitely get into private sales, meme coins, and spot. And if you've got like a lot of money, I would urge you to get into private sales and spot and then keep a good little bag on the side and just throw shit at the meme coins and see what happens. Because that's what I do, you know? So yeah, I hope that's helpful, guys. I hope this gives you some context as to which one you should pick and which ones I enjoy the most and kind of the differences between them. And also, if you want to get into private sales, you want to get into the best meme call plays, join our Telegram group below. There's over 5,000 people in there. Literally 3 days ago, it was at 4,000. So it's growing crazy right now. And same with my YouTube channel. It's blowing up. And I'd love to see you in there. And say hi to me when you get in there. Just at me. It's r_interstellar. And beware of scammers, because there's like a million of them that all impersonate me and try and sell you on some copy trading thing. I will never, ever, ever reach out to you. The only way for you to contact me is by you messaging me at my Telegram in that. And it says co-founder next to it. And I'll put it on the screen somewhere here in this video so you don't get scammed. But yeah, I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. Subscribe. See you later. Peace.